Hey you guys, my name is Imani and you are watching All About Janet TV. Guys, welcome back to my channel, All About Janet TV, for all things Janet Jackson. My name is Imani, and in today's video, I would like to talk about my top 5 favorite Janet Jackson performances. And when it comes to these performances, I kind of wanted to explain each performance in order from exactly when it happened, the songs that she were performing, and why I consider them my favorite performances. And once I finish listing all of my favorite performances, I hope this will help you guys understand why Janet Jackson will always be one of the greatest female entertainers of all time. Now, my first favorite performance is the 1987 American Music Awards when Janet was performing Control. This was around the time when Janet was only 21 years old, the age that I am today, and what was the most exciting and memorable moment about this night was that Janet won her first big award. Her first award was for Favorite Soul R&B Video by a female artist, and she was nominated against Aretha Franklin, Whitney Houston, and Tina Turner. To me, this was such a tough category for all 4 women, being that they're all iconic and legendary in their own way, and this just truly shows how great Janet was back in 1987 and even today. If you checked out this performance on YouTube, you could even see Whitney Houston clapping for Janet. And one thing I love is when a queen supports another queen. Now here is a 60-second video of Janet performing Control at the 1987 American Music Awards. My second favorite Janet Jackson performance was at the 1993 Video Music Awards when Janet performed That's the Way Love Goes and If. Janet Jackson was truly in her prime and had all the girls shook, and at this point nobody was on her level of entertainment. Her abs were also amazing, and if you know Janet, Janet has always had some of the best abs out here in the business. Being that she was the last performer of that night, just imagine if any other performers had to go on after her. I don't think anybody else would want to perform after her. It was like everyone just had to see her performance, and that was it, because she completely shut it down. With this performance, I felt that she was out to make a statement, being that she is more than just a Jackson, and she was going to stick around the music industry for a long time. Now here is a 60-second performance of Janet Jackson performing at the 1993 VMAs. Thank you. Janet Jackson performance would have to be the 1997 American Music Awards when she performed Together Again. Now, if you know me personally, Together Again has always been one of my favorite songs by Janet Jackson. Whether it's the original version that was a very up-tempo dance hit from the Velvet Rope album, the Deeper remix, or the 1997 DJ Premier remix that Janet performed at the 1997 AMAs. When looking back at Janet's 1997 performance, I just love how smooth and crisp the choreography was. And shout out to Mike Andrews, who choreographed this amazing piece, and may he rest in peace. My favorite part about this performance was the intro when Janet enters the stage and how she exits the stage, and everything was just so on point that Janet gave the girls a run for their money. What is so amazing about this performance is when you see Janet dancing with the original kids. She called her backup dancers her kids. The kids, they each had such a special gift when they always danced together. You know, they definitely created magic on stage. I don't think anyone would be able to come close to the replication of that choreography for years to come. Now, here is a 60-second video of Janet performing Together Again at the 1997 American Music Awards. My fourth favorite Janet Jackson performance would have to be when she performed Doesn't Really Matter at the 2000s VMAs. Now, when it comes to this performance, this is what you call a performance. It was very intricate and innovative, that your eyes were just glued on Janet to where you did not want to miss not one single dance step that Janet was doing on stage. I love when she starts doing the breakdown and the audience are screaming, "Go Janet, go Janet." Now, with this performance compared to what other entertainers are out here doing today, it's just very hard to find that within other artists nowadays. Now, when it comes to her look in this performance, which it was very dark and very edgy, I kind of wish Janet, you know, I just wish she would have came out with more fun and bright colors, exactly how she did it when it came to the Doesn't Really Matter music video. But Janet has always been known for many of her iconic styles, and whenever you would see her, she would always bring something new and something fresh, not only when it comes to music and choreography, but also when it comes to fashion. Now, here is a 60-second video of Janet performing Doesn't Really Matter at the 2000 VMAs. Edit.
I'm not afraid to
guest's favorite Janet Jackson performance would have to be when she performed All For You at the 2001 MTV Icon. My favorite part about this performance would definitely have to be when Janet starts breaking down to the choreography for You Ain't Right, and her dancers then follow in pursuit. Now, for those who aren't familiar with the song or the choreography for You Ain't Right, this is a song off of the All For You album, and if you've watched the All For You tour, you would see Janet performing and doing the choreography to the song You Ain't Right. I also mentioned in my first video, which I did a Q&A, how I felt that You Ain't Right deserved to be a single along with some of Janet's other underrated hits. And I just love how each of Janet's background dancers were each dressed up in a different music video that Janet has ever done all the way up into the All For You era. Some of the looks that I saw was one dancer dressing up as Rhythm Nation, another dancer dressed up from her music video of All Right, Runaway, Scream, What's It Gonna Be, If, and many other iconic Janet Jackson music video looks that Janet has done before the All For You era, which around that time, she's already had many iconic moments already under her belt. Now here is a 60-second video of Janet performing All For You at the 2001 MTV Icon.
Sorry, Miss Jackson, technical difficulty. Let's run that again one more time from the top, please.
All right. Now!
Guys, there you have it, my top 5 favorite Janet Jackson performances. And for those who haven't checked out any of these performances, I will definitely leave the links down in my description. That way you can check them out and see why Janet is truly one of the best female entertainers out here today. Hopefully this video was very informative and something that you enjoy. And I think that is all that I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for tuning into my channel and all the love and support that I've been receiving. You guys just don't know how much this truly means to me. You know, this definitely keeps me motivated for whenever I come out with new videos. And again, you know, just thank you guys so much for all the amount of love and support on my first two videos, and I know for this upcoming video. And also, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. That way you will be on the lookout when I drop my next video. And again, my name is Imani, and thank you guys so much for tuning into my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Enjoy.